Hey everyone, my name's Annette from Miracle Babies Newborn Nursery. I just thought I'd do a short video today as I'm putting Samantha, the baby monkey, together today. So I just thought I'd show you where we're up to. So of course, as you can see, we've got her little head, her hands, her arms, her body, and her legs. So I put little plugs in her legs, and she'll have one in her head, as well as a neck ring. The arms are a little bit small to put a plug in, so I'll put something in there to plug it up. And these zip ties I put in the body, which hold, or put in the body in the rings here, which hold all the limbs on really nice and tight. So right now I'm going to get each limb and I'm going to fill it with my glass bead and a little bit of a little bit of polyfill, and close them all up, and then I'll do some more video. Okay, so I thought I'd video putting the weights in the limbs. So I just have this, which is fine glass bead. It's almost like sand, and it gets everywhere when it does fall away. So what I do is I've got a little medicine cup, and I just fill each limb. I don't fill it to the top. I probably three-quarter fill it, especially with the monkeys. We don't need it to be too heavy. So I don't know if you can just see in there. I've got that in there. And then I just get a little bit of polyfill and fill that in there. Really stock it in. And then the cap, we want it to fit nice and snug, so sometimes I have to pull out a little bit. Now this fine glass bead, it gives, when you give the baby's limbs a press, it feels a little more realistic. Some people use the coarse glass bead. I also have those, but I normally use them for the body. And that's because when you give them a little squish, it feels a bit not as realistic, a little bit like there's stuff inside. So that'll be right, because once it goes into the body, it'll sit nicely. And then with the arm, like it's so, the hole is so tiny, but with these medicine glasses you can really squish in. See? It's gone up to the top now. Oh no, not quite. A little bit more. Okay, so this will have really tiny, lucky I've got really tiny fingers. So just push that in. But like I said, with the arms, I don't have plugs, they're just too tiny. So I've just got some cosmetic wedge and cut them. And I'll just put that just in there, just in the entrance, so nothing's gonna come out. So I'll go ahead and I'll do the other leg and the other arm, and then I'll show you attaching to its body. Okay, so now to its body. Some of the bodies I get, I just have them come with the strings in. Some people use the strings, especially in child-friendly dolls. I personally take the strings out. I don't think they're as supportive. And I put in zip ties. Now they're not just any zip ties, they're very small headed zip ties. So when I use them, they sit nicely into the body and don't sort of really stick out. So these just get fed through each of the holes in the body. So obviously I've got a neck hole, two leg and two arm. So it's as simple as that. And then they'll be ready to go. I'll do another leg one so you can see, and then I'll do the others. So nice and quick. Through there. See? Okay, I'll do the others and get back to you so we can put the limbs on the body. Okay, so now we've got the body all with the zip ties in and the legs with their weights. So we'll put them on now. So you've just got to make sure that the neck zip tie is to the back and that you're getting the right limb for the right side. So we just basically put it in there so it's covering in the little groove. Make sure the zip tie is in its little feed. Like that. And then we pull it, tighten it, I should say. And you've got to really make sure it is tight. It's quite easy for it not to be tight enough and for that limb to fall out. And also, I think it's happened to most reborn udders, sometimes it's just the way the actual connection sits. So the other leg now. Once again, just pulling the zip tie tight. It's very cute. And then the arms. So of course we need a little bit of polyfill for inside the arm. I tend to put a little bit extra in because especially if a child is playing with these, even an adult, we all like them. Over time the polyfill tends to wear away and then we're left with it a bit saggy. So a little bit extra. So it will last the life of the baby, which is a long time. So just getting that arm situated in the correct position. This little baby is to be born in a few days, so that's why I'm getting it ready for a young girl's birthday. See, so it's like popping back out, but I can just put that in and it'll be fine. So the other arm. This one, put it into position and tighten. Now I can tighten that well off video, but just so you can see. That is how the body will look. So next I work on little Bubby's head. We've got the neck ring, which I'll put on soon, and the plug, which will plug up once I've put all the weight inside. But first what I like to do is I've opened the nasal passage on this monkey, and so everything doesn't come out from her nose. And to give it a little bit of depth, I just put a bit of black felt in behind the nose. Now I just place a bit of glue on the back of the felt. The glue actually dries clear and it's really good because it is waterproof and it is gel based, so it's like pliable, it'll move, it won't just sit still. So I just put that up behind the nose. Can be a little bit hard to get in there. And and let that dry for a few hours. That's dry inside. Next, I just put the neck ring on. Now that just goes this way and will sit into the groove. So with these monkeys, they're a little bit more stiff than some of the other kits we use. But basically, I'll push that on and that'll come all the way around. So neck ring is on. The best thing about a neck ring is when the head actually goes onto the body, it'll allow the head to move back and forwards easier. And it also stops the head from falling off because it's now got that little extra lip there. I don't know if you can see, which when the zip tie holds it on, it won't. It'll be nice and tight in there, so it'll sit nicely. So the next thing I want to do is put weight inside the baby's head. Okay, so next I'm going to put the weight inside the monkey's head. First what I do is I get just some polyfill and put it in there. I just like to have that close to the head before I put the weight in. So it seems like a lot, but this really compacts when it gets inside. The next thing I want to do is, with all my babies, I put the powder wafers in. So they're like a little wafer that is scented like baby powder. I put one in the body and I also will put half in the body and half in just behind the nose. So it does emit that baby powder smell for quite some time. So just put that in behind the nose there. And that's good. Next, I've got the stocking. That's what I put my glass bead in, so it doesn't obviously fall out and be rattling around inside the head. And inside the head and body, I use a different kind of glass bead. It's a coarse glass bead, so it's not as fine as the glass bead that I used inside the limbs. So basically just put the stocking into the head. If you've got something like tape or something, you can just put that there. Open up the opening and just pour that in. Now it'll fill rather quickly, so you just have to keep maneuvering it around. A lot of people asked how I think about how much weight has to go in the body and head. Unless it's a custom baby that I have to make it a particular weight, I'll just do what feels natural. So if it's too light, it's just going to feel pretty much like a doll. And if it's too heavy, well, it's not going to be enjoyable. This way you can just take your time and bit by bit. So that feels good. So I just tie that off. Now with the coarse glass bead, it won't come out of that stocking. If it was fine, it would come through. So next, put some more polyfill in there. Squeeze the head to feel. If it feels too squishy, you need more polyfill. If it feels hard, it'll actually distort the shape of the face, so you don't want too much. After that, we just pop in the plug and we're ready to attach the head to the body. Okay, so we're not quite ready to attach the head to the body because we need to put fill in the body first. So just like I did with the head, I first put some polyfill into the bottom of the body. Then I attach the weight. So I've got another piece of stocking, but this isn't the foot part, so I have to tie a knot in one end and then put the weight in. Now this is going to be a body weight, so we need more to go in the body, obviously, than we do in the head. So roughly about the size of an orange, really. You can just pour all this in there. It's the size of a small orange and should feel nice inside. I also put the powder wafer inside that bag. It will still emit the smell, but it just keeps it from rattling around inside the body. So that just goes inside the body. And then we just need to fill the rest of the body up with polyfill. If you wanted to make it heavier at this stage, you just make another weight bag and put it in. So remember, like I said with the arms, I like to put extra weight polyfill in. So over time that it seems to dissipate and then it gets all really squishy. So if I put a little bit extra in, it's a little bit more solid to begin with. But over months, it gets very, very soft. Okay, so now to put the head on. Just put the zip tie in there. Basically, just put the head on. Tighten the zip tie. So make sure all the polyfill is in the body. We don't want it hanging out the back of the neck. If it is hanging out the back of the neck, we can simply trim it or pull it. It'll come out. So I'll tighten that up soon. But that's our little baby monkey. So the next process is for it. I give it a haircut. It's got quite long hair, as you can see. So I cut that down so it's about 1 inch to 2 inch. Otherwise, it's just going to get tangled. And then the last process is to cut all the zip ties nice and fine so they're not scratching, and then dress. So we'll show you that soon. Okay, so since the monkey's all together now, the next step is to cut the ties. So for that, I use a sharp scalpel type of knife. This one is actually a little bit blunt. Just make sure all the ties are very tight, giving them the extra pull. And I cut the tie in a V shape, so down on one side and then down on the opposite side. So it just pops off and there's nothing there that will scratch a child or adult. Down on one side, down on the other. Oh, that one I cut too much. See, so it can be very easily, so I've just got to put another tie into that. Easy fixed, and better done now than later. So just pop that in there again. Nice and tight. Last one, which will be a time of birth. And there we go. So what I do now, like I said before, his hair's really, her hair is really long, so I'll trim that just with a pair of scissors, and then time to dress. So with the trimming, just pull out all the hair and just trim it to the length I want. As you can see. So we don't want to have it too long, because having it too long will just, it'll just get really, really tangled. But at the same time, we want it to sort of curve around the back of the arm. This one's going to be a girl, like I said, so I won't trim as much as the hair on top, because I want to place some little ponytails in that. So I'll show you when she's done. Okay, so now she's been born and she's received a little haircut. Sometimes you can cut a little bit shorter, but I think just leave it at that length at this time. I've cut her hair a little bit shorter, so I'm going to give her two little ponies. So I've just got some clear bands. It's just as simple as putting one in each side. Now the little girl who's getting this is not a really girly girl, so I'm not going to make it too fancy. I'm just going to put a couple of blue ribbons in her hair. So it's not too lacy kind. So you can do the hair in anything, any way you want. The boys, I normally sort of spray them out a little bit so it's kind of punky looking. The girls, a little top-notch pony, or these little ones. So I just put a little ribbon in each side. Fiddly. So thin, this ribbon. The ribbons are light and the bands are not too invasive, so she can take them out. Not doing a very quick job here. So there, you'll spread the little hair out. I won't do it too much yet because still got to put her clothes on. So that's her. And then normally I like to put just a nappy on them. Huggy's nappy looks very cute. That's a bit big. I'll have to use a preemie Huggy's nappy. That looks so cute. Okay, and then she just needs her outfit, which I'll grab. Won't be a moment. Okay, so like I said, I'm not going too fancy with the outfit. Just a little pink onesie. Put on. Now, part of a monkey's cuteness is to see them then. Sorry, the video cut off before, so just put on this little onesie, and I like to fold it underneath so you can still see the nappy. I think it really looks cute just like that. So now I just want to show you me putting it in the box. Okay, so to start off, this is Samantha. And she is a chimpanzee. So she needs her little hospital wristband. So we'll put that on. Just put that on like that. So now she's got her name on her. Just cut that away. here we have her box that she'll be going home in. I'll just move. So you all can see. So there's her box. So in her box she has so far just a little green blanket. And I'll put her in the box, say bye, going to my new mummy. So I'll just lay her just across the middle. So she'll look like that. So her new mummy will get a toy to go with Samantha. Also, a banana shaped bottle. So this is really good actually, because when the person wants to feed the little monkey, it looks like it's sort of feeding. It's really cute. So I'll just tuck that under her arm like that. She also gets a bib, M for monkey of course. So I just fold that up, and a spare nappy. I'll just put the nappy in the side there. I might put the bib like that so they can see. It's a girl, so she needs a brush, so I'll give her the pink brush and comb set. Powder, it's just something fun. I know it's a bit hard to use on a monkey, but it's always fun. I give a conditioner, hair conditioning solution. So it's just conditioner and water, and they can just spray it on the hair and then brush it. It makes it get less tangly. Elmo baby wipes. You've got to have baby wipes. And they're so cute. She's got a little outfit. It'll fit her nice and snugly. The little girl that's getting her isn't very girly, like I mentioned, so I thought I'd do the green because it's sort of jungly. Shame they didn't have them in monkeys, but it's still so cute. So I'll just fold that up and put that there too. Might put the bib on top of that because that really stands out. Now, just got a little washer here, face washer, so they can wash over her face, and I put that with a little It's a Girl notice. I'll just get some baby shower ribbon to wrap around that. They're just cute little nifty extras. It's just like when you're getting a gift. You like all those little extras to look at. So that'll go in there too. Okay. Now Samantha has a photo card made up. So that'll go on there too. She also has a birth certificate. So I'll just roll that one up. And put a bit of baby shower ribbon around that too. Now all of my babies come with different things. I mean, obviously a monkey has certain needs, like a banana bottle. So a reborn baby isn't going to come with a banana bottle. I just tend to go on what people talk to me, what they need, and who it's for. So just there. So that can just go in there, like, onto the side. So that's how she looks so far. Just one out of four. So it's a nice little package. Then pretty much last is care instructions. So anyone who gets my babies will know what to do. So I normally put that on top of there. I'll normally put like a little bubble wrap over the top, and then the lid goes on. So I'll do the bubble wrap in a minute. So it'll be just like that, ready to go. And I'll put some baby shower ribbon around it as well, because this one's
falling in love with you is coming home.
And it'll be all
you're always
up.
There, although
so
I'm mostly gone. You took my hand and then you let me leave. You said, go light up the room, and so that's what I did. Light up the room.